Oh, look at that. Oh, man. Yeah, for those inclined, there's nothing like a cold one. In moderation, of course. But come the 1st of February, satisfying one's thirst will hit the wallet harder.
The price of a pint of beer or a cocktail will increase at pubs and bars around the country from next month.
Right now, an average pint costs around $12. Once the tax hikes kick in, that pint will cost $15. That means I'm going to start leaving the pub before it's my shout. I do that already, but now I'll race out. And fancy drinks aren't safe either, with a Negroni, Mojito or my signature cocktail, a banana flipper dipper, set to cost more than $24. As you'd imagine, the industry isn't too happy.
Australians pay 40% more on the tax for spirits than they do in New Zealand, and 7 times more than in the US. It is cheaper to buy a bottle of Bundaberg rum in Los Angeles than it is here in Bundaberg.
But taxes on things like booze and durries are sometimes referred to as a sin tax. The money recouped is, in theory, supposed to offset the harms visited on society.
Alcohol doesn't only harm the person at the acute time, it increases the risk of injuries. It has long-term health impacts on you, which costs the healthcare system quite a bit.
OK, that's a very good point, but let's hear from a beer expert.
Why do they tax the things we love? Sorry, mate, I'm hammered.
Oh. Wow, how hot was that pro beer guy? Anyway, the industry is calling for the government to pour the tax increase down the drain.
We are asking for an immediate freeze on the tax on Australian spirits for 2 years. So that will give us an opportunity to sit down with the government and have a conversation about how we can fix this.
It's not just the person that drinks that's impacted by this. It's their loved ones, it's their family, it's the broader community.
So is your drinks tab fair game for the tax man, or is this the slow death of a great Aussie pub?
So what, $15 for a pint?
Mm-hmm.
At what point, Nick, like, do you think you would stop drinking? You know, sorry, this is a question from us at work.
Whoa.
Because of your...
Is my wife talking to you through that headset?
This is an
interesting... I don't know, I like a beer. Hopefully their, like, interest rates, they go up for a bit, then they'll dip, you know? I'm not sure how the excise works, but
do you feel...
like a beer. A few beers, $15, it is... It's starting to get a little bit ridiculous.
And the scary thing is it might encourage home brewing.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, no.
Yes.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm 36. I've avoided home brewing, barbecuing and golf. I don't know how I've dodged the trifecta
beard,
of loser.
You look like someone who could do all those three things.
Probably.
Because there was a time, sort of like the late 2000s, early 2010s, where, like, I guess, you know, people were maybe struggling a bit and would brew a lot of beer at home, and you'd go to a party and everyone would be like, hey, you try this, I just brewed in my bathtub or whatever. And you'd feel obliged to do it just because you're trying to be polite. But it was inevitably poison, like every single time.
Horrible. Did you do this, Michael?
Yeah, of course. You're going to try it. Someone's offering you beer they've brewed.
No, I mean, did you do
home brewing? No. I was into vodka. I was...
Jeez.
I had a crack at vodka. It was pretty
drinking
bad.
It or making it?
No, yeah, both. No, I had a crack making vodka. It was pretty bad.
Okay.
I think also it may have been illegal. Let's move on to literally anything else, please.
Now...